We thank you. We give you praise. We give you honor. We give you adoration. I thank you, Lord, for this great opportunity. I thank you for this beautiful morning, Lord. I thank you, King of Glory, that we are gathered in your presence. Ancient of Days, that I am, that I am. Omnipotent, Omniscient. Father, Lord, I pray at this hour that the preaching of your word to your children will make an impact in their life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As we gather here, O Lord, the Spirit of the living God will brood over this atmosphere in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, Lord, every spirit of destruction be destroyed by fire in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we thank you, we give you praise, we give you honor, we give you adoration. In Jesus' mighty name, we have
prayed.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'd like to thank our Daddy the Lord for this great opportunity. It's a privilege standing in the pulpit this far, preaching, and this is what I love doing. Like our Daddy said, the barrister in the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm happy to work for God. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There is power in the name of Jesus. Believe you can stand up on your feet.
There is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain.
There is an rising for your sake. Hallelujah.
Yes, I love you.
Rising for your problem.
Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain.
Amen. I bring to us a topic, the Holy Spirit title, take your eyes from the natural, visualizing into the supernatural. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Take your eyes from the natural, visualizing into the supernatural. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do you understand that? Amen. Give God the glory. Amen. Let's open our Bible to 1 Corinthians chapter 2. I read verse 9 and 10. Are we there? If you are there, say yeah, yeah. I read. However, as it is written, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind has conceived what God has prepared for those who love him. Hallelujah. For God has revealed it to us by his Spirit. The Spirit searches all things, even the deep things of God. Hallelujah. The Bible is saying here that no eyes have seen, no ear has heard. No mind has conceived what God has prepared for those who love him. The Bible is not saying he's about to prepare. What God has prepared, he has already prepared your future. Hallelujah. He has already prepared where you are going to. Hallelujah. If you are going to enjoy enlargement, you must learn to take your eyes from the natural things. You must take your eyes into the future. Visualize your future. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because if you don't look into your future, you remain in your present. You'll be stuck there. There are different kinds of people in this world. There are some that are always analyzing their problem. They stay in their problem. They don't want to move forward. But there are some that always talk about their present. When you look about your present, you are so comfortable about your present, you will be stuck there. There are some, they are celebrating their testimony. They just want to remain there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Am I talking to someone here?
Yes.
When you over-celebrate your victory, you will remain there. Look forward, because God is taking you out of there. Taking you forward. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do not look at where you are. Because God is moving you forward.
Amen.
Amen. Let's go to Genesis chapter 13, verse 14. Genesis 13. Genesis is just the first, it's not the last. Hallelujah. Is someone getting me? Amen. We read verse 14. Okay, let's read from 13. It says, now the men of Sodom were wicked and were sinning greatly against the Lord. The Lord said to Abraham, after Lot had parted from him, lift up your eyes from where you are and look north and south, east and west. Hallelujah. Is someone hearing me?
Yes,
it was after Lot was separated from Abraham that he could see his future. God said, look up. He did not say, look down. So when we look down, we remain down. When we sit down, we remain dead. When we are standing, we look up. When an airplane wants to fly, it looks up. So wherever your eyes look at is where your future is. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Am I talking to someone here today? Amen. It was outside love was separated from him before he could see beyond what God wants him to become. When you lift up your eyes to God, that is where the secret lies. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 When we look up to God, there is restoration. There is compensation. When we look up to God, the things that we feel that we will just begin to think about our problem every time. God is not looking at that. God is telling us to move. To move forward. Leave where you are. And stop meditating on your problem. And stop meditating on your scars. This is where this person hits me. This is where I have this. Meditating on all the scars in your body. God said, drop it and look up. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Until you look up, before you can see the way forward. Anytime you look down at your problem, you remain stuck. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Abraham was in a place of heartbreak. He was thinking about what Sodom had done to him. What Sodom had done. What the people of Sodom have done to him. What people have done to him. But God told him, look up. Leave all the heartbreak. Leave all the disappointment. Yes, the place of letdown. Leave it now. Place all the betrayal down. And God said, no, 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 no. Lift up your eyes to the east, west, north, and south. That is where you are going to get what, where I'm taking you to. Hallelujah.
Amen.
See the things that are unseen as a Christian. When we visualize things that we cannot see, claim to be rich. Prophesy to yourself, I am rich in the Lord. Do not tell someone that I have nothing. When you begin to say you have nothing, you will remain that way. There will be empty pockets every time. When you begin to think about you are deteriorated in your problem, you are there searching for the solution. You are thinking retrogression of your problem. I am telling you, you will remain there forever. For God is telling you to look up. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Am I talking to someone in the house today? Can I preach?
Yes.
Let's go to Isaiah chapter 46. Isaiah chapter 46, I read the 10. Are we there?
Yes.
It says, I make known the end from the beginning. Can we hear that?
Yes.
I make known the end from the beginning. From ancient times, what is still to come? I say, my purpose will stand, and I will do all that I please. Can someone read it in James for me? Hallelujah.
Declaring the end from the beginning, and from ancient times the things that were not yet done, saying, my counsel shall stand, and I will do all my pleasure.
Hallelujah. Can you hear what God is saying? He's declaring the end from the beginning. That is to say, the future. We are looking at the present. We are looking at where we started. Hallelujah. Our future is God's past tense. Is someone hearing me? Because God has prepared that thing. He is preparing the things from the hand. But we are still looking at our beginning. Why not visualize on that thing that God has placed for you? Hallelujah. Amen. Look up. That's what God told Abraham. When you look up, you look forward, you look away, and once you don't sit down, you cannot stay down. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Anyone that looks up, stays up. Amen.
Amen.
Where you look, determines where you go. Amen. So look away from your situation. If you look at your situation, you remain in that situation. If you allow people to sympathize with you, a million sorry will not solve that problem. You only end up telling other people your problem. And what they will tell you is sorry. It brings no solution. Your solution is in your hands. The Lord is saying, look up into the future. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. God is busy moving us forward. He's not ready to sympathize with us. His own business is to move us forward. But when we refuse to move forward, he looks at us in a distance. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What have you, or are you still going through? Somebody has gone through it before. Whatever thing you are going through today, someone has gone through it. Don't die inside. Tell your neighbor, don't die inside.
Don't die inside.
Come out of that shit.
Come out of that mess.
The Lord has something for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do not allow people to sympathize with you. They have no solution to it. Why did God tell Abraham to lift up his eyes? Because his eyes were down, just like people of today. We look down at our problem. We look down at our scars. We look down at those things people have told us. We look down on all those things, the things we passed through in our family. I was like this. I could not eat 3 square meals. But what are you eating now? What are you